introduction of Mr. and Mrs. Canavan.
Thank you. just shaking hands. That'll get better later on. Yeah, I know, mate, you're married. You're married. Ladies and gentlemen, I just want to say welcome to Karma Samui on behalf of myself and all the staff. It's been a pleasure to meet all of you. I think I've pretty well met everyone around the tables. I'd just like to say a couple of thank yous. And the first one goes to Kun Su. Where is Sue? Is she somewhere? Kun Su, our lead coordinator, is over back there. Who has done a really fabulous job in working with Dave and Amanda and putting this special day together. I'd also like you to put your hands together for all my kitchen team, good Stefano, good as is, done a great job and put the day together. It's been a real pleasure to have you all with us from all parts of the world, from UK, from Ireland, from Australia, for them coming down experiencing Karma, and it's been really, really special for us to see this special day. So congratulations, you guys. Come back for your anniversary. We do a very special rate for anniversaries. Yes. Bring all your friends.
If it's free, you might
have free. Baby, speak to Sue. Your room is free.
And the rest of us.
We do a special deal. A very special deal. So
we sleep in that room.
There you go. Not tonight, but maybe on the first anniversary. So thanks so much for being with us. I hope you enjoyed dinner. The night is yet young. We have a couple of speeches to go. I'm going to pass over to Tristan right now. We want to get you down to the beach after the speeches. That's a really important part of the night. For those of you who are new in Thailand, letting the Thai lanterns loose is a very special moment. It has a lot of significance for the Thai people and also for the bride and groom tonight. So after Amanda has a couple of words to you, we ask you to follow her at the front door. We're going to congregate on the beach, let some lanterns go, and then come and join us down on the bottom deck. We have a DJ there, we have plenty of cocktails, plenty of drinks, and the night is still young. So please enjoy, and a real pleasure to meet you all. Thanks very much for being here. I'm going to pass over right now to the man who's done a fantastic job tonight, Tristan. He was, of course, our master of ceremony. Give him a round of applause. The best. He did a fantastic job. I thought it was a really special ceremony. I thought it was very real. And please pay him a tribute tonight. He's going to introduce all the speeches. And I hope you enjoyed the meal. And thanks for being with us. Round of applause for Mr. Tristan.
I'd just like to give a special thank you while we're all clapping hands to Mark, his beautiful wife Danielle, and their beautiful daughter for taking care of everything for David and Amanda this afternoon and this evening. Later, I'm sure. I'm not sure how many of you have realised, but we're actually sitting in a restaurant called Padma. And Padma has actually come in very handy for me because we're going to have 5 speeches tonight and they're actually all going to relate to the name of the restaurant. So the first person I'd actually like to invite up to the podium to make his speech is a man who's a Jethro Tull fan. Those of you who have met him, he's a great guy. He's spent a lot of time... He's laughing now.
On my leg,
yeah? Peter Sim, father of the bride.
Say go.
Really, I want to welcome everybody first of all on behalf of Carolyn and I. Everybody that had to travel a long distance, people from Africa, the States, Australia, UK, Scotland, Dubai, and the locals. It's been a fabulous day and a beautiful service. How good did today go? How beautiful were they?
Thank you.
absolutely magic. I was wondering why Dave and Amanda picked the 20th of February 2009. Charles Darwin's anniversary, 200th birthday, was actually last week. And if you know Dave at all, you know that Charles Darwin is his hero, or one of. And that was a special day last week. So I thought, I wonder why the 20th. So I had a bit of a look around and found history told me that in 1472, Scotland and Orkney transferred from Norway to Scotland to make a dowry claim. In 1547, Edward VI of England was crowned. In 1927, Sidney Cordio was born. And in 1986, Britain and France announced plans to build the Channel Tunnel. Well, that's good for you guys, wasn't it? In 1962, John Glenn became the first American to orbit the Earth. And there was lots of other stuff I found about cricket matches between the Aussies and the Poms that the Aussies just thrashed the Poms, but I didn't like them. But the other information I found out was today, the 20th of February 2009, is the only English Australian wedding to occur on the coast of Norway. Dave and Amanda and how wonderful they are together and individually. What a beautiful person each one of them is. One of them is talented.
Which one?
You, Amanda.
Yeah. Which one? Beautiful, really good, a really good organiser.
That's not
well, then there's Amanda. Amanda's always been a delight, actually, as a daughter. She's been a delightful girl from dirty nappies to the current time. I reflect back to the time when she used to run around the back garden naked under the sprinkler.
She's still
dirty. She's still
Yeah, no sprinklers anymore.
I'm keen on making some money here. What time is it?
Hurry on!
He's got such a connection with the real world. Not so much with the spiritual, but anything that moves and wriggles. He's a fine fellow to do anything with. He's got some great talent. He can strum a guitar, he can kick a ball. They call it football, but it hasn't got any pointy ends. He always enjoys himself wherever you are. And I suppose the other thing I was going to say, I was thinking about, this marriage doesn't come without some risk. The risk that they'll encounter in the future, the risk of Dave and Amanda on a cruise perhaps, cruising around the ocean and running across some sharks and Dave jumping overboard to get a real experience. And I guess there's a risk for Dave, because they've had a great life in Thailand. And they've been spoiled with that brilliant time, but Dave doesn't have a man to cook. Or so, or do washing. So when they settle up somewhere, I think it's going to be Australia, we're going to have to teach you how to press some buttons, fold some clothes, and rub that hot thing up and down. Alright, I don't know what else I want to say except to ask everybody to raise their glasses.
You've got
85 minutes
left.
Okay, raise their glasses. Just for all you share, here's to the future for all your plans together, and here's to the love, laughter, and happiness ever after. To Amanda and Dave.
Thank you, Peter. I have no idea what pressing a button is, but I can only guess seems to have been a pat home in the last 2 weeks. But turn right up to the microphone. I actually don't know a lot about. I've unfortunately not had a lot of time spent with this person. But judging by today, and apart from being the third best dressed gentleman in the room, aside from Dave and myself, Mr. Andy Canavan.
If you've got anything less than 45 minutes, forget it. You're lost. Please, one speaker on. The artists, honestly, what are they like? I spent ages, months preparing this speech. Then Anne and I were sitting out by the pool today, and she said, right, what's your speech like? What's the content? She said, right, no jokes about Irish, gays, blondes, no mentioning Dave's previous girlfriends, no mention of his strangulated testicles. Oh, oh God, did I mention? Sorry, Dave.
No, sorry, that was.
Ladies and gentlemen, new family, new friends. It's been a great day. It's hard to believe that 30 years ago, we had two daughters and we were thinking, God, this time's got to be third time lucky. Unfortunately, Dave turned up and, listen, there he was, a little baby boy, and who could believe 30 years later, this little baby boy has turned into a bloody big girl that he is today. Not mentioning any girlfriends particularly, there's this one blonde girl that he did go out with, and he was taken out in his car and he said, you go and check if the windscreen wipers are working? And she said, yes they are. Yes they are, no they're not. Yes they are, no they're not. He was going out with a girl with half an ear for a while. She was a knife thrower's assistant. He wasn't a very good knife thrower, obviously. But as time went by, he just saw less and less of her. Hey, listen. He met a man there not long before Helen's wedding in Mauritius. And he actually didn't fetch Amanda with him, he fetched Shirley. And what a great partner Shirley was. Of all of Dave's girlfriends, who I'm not going to mention, they all had to pass the interview test, the interrogation test, between Helen and Victoria. Honestly, none of them passed the test. They all wished that Shirley could have married him. As it turned out, when they met Amanda, she passed with flying colours. She's the only girlfriend he's had that has been, that they've actually spoken to. And what a treasure she's turned out, she really has. Last time we were in the UK, when Amanda and Dave came over to, went to Centre Parks, which is like just cycling around from hook to hook. And on our way back up to Aberdeen, we stopped in Edinburgh for the Edinburgh Tattoo. It's a military tattoo. It's just loads of marching bands and that sort of thing. And while we were there, I fancied going into the National Gallery, the National Art Gallery, and Amanda fancied going too. And so I went in there to look at the Palettos, the Joshua Reynolds, the Titians, all the very good paintings were in there. We came across this one just around the corner, which was slightly different from the rest, different style altogether. There was three black men sitting naked on a park bench. And the two on the outside had black penises, and the one in the middle had a pink penis. And the curator of the establishment came up to us and he was saying, oh, what's all the reasoning behind this? You know, what did the artist have in mind? And he was saying that, well, it indicates the sexual emasculation of Afro-Americans by predominantly middle-class white patriarchal society. It results cultural and social oppression of gay men in contemporary society. I thought, wow, that really is good. Anyway, he went off, and this little Scots guy came sidling up to us and said, it's got nothing to do with Afro-Americans at all. He said, I painted that picture. It's three Scottish coal miners, and the one in the middle went home for lunch. I line of work, and we're always interested in getting people from different backgrounds to blend into engineering. And I've got these two Indian guys in. This one Indian guy, he said he used to be a businessman. He used to run a pantyhose stall in Delhi. And I thought, yeah, he might be all right. He's got a little bit of business acumen. He can forecast, he can do accounts and that sort of thing. Okay, we'll take a risk with you. What about you, matey? I'm a diesel fitter. Yeah, that sounds really good, because in the line of work that I'm dealing with, it's all to do with ships and marine engineering and that sort of thing. You'll be ideal. I said, which company did you used to work for? Oh, I said, I used to work for my mate in the store. How come, he said? How come, I said? I said, well, he would see the ladies coming in, and he'd shout, pantyhose, pantyhose, and I'd come round and say, diesel fitter, diesel fitter. Right, a few sexual anecdotes here. I'm sure you want to hear them. This guy walked into the bedroom with a sheep under his arm, and he said, "This is the pig I have sex with when you have a headache." And his wife says, "I think you'll find that's a sheep." And she says, "I think you'll find that's a sheep." This old man and this old woman. The sheep. She tried to do something a little bit exclusive. She went down to Brazilian, just for a change. And she came out of the bathroom, and she went with the bathrobe, "Soup of pussy!" And he said, "I'll have the soup." Oh, sorry, is that another one I should have crossed off the list? Hey, David used to call his friend that Spider-Man. He didn't have any superpowers, but he just couldn't get out of the bath.
Andy?
Hey, tell you what, we've been so tired sometimes. You'll speak next, man.
Did you read that lot as well?
We've been so tired sometimes. I've just been waking up. Sometimes in the morning, I've been waking up feeling grumpy. Rewind. I've been waking up grumpy, and other times I've just let her sleep. Sorry, Al. Hey, if at least you don't succeed, skydiving isn't for you, alright? I used to know this guy with a map, with a road map tattooed on his back. He was a bit of a git, but at least you knew where you were with him. There's this guy that I played badminton with on a Wednesday night. He's 45, he's almost a confirmed bachelor because he can't get a woman. And he put an ad in the local Evening Express saying, "Wife wanted." He got 200 replies, one saying, "You can have mine." When we were telling people at work that we're coming off to Thailand to my son's wedding, they sort of fixed with their minds, Is he getting married to a Thai bride? And I had to say, no, he's going to have to make do with an Aussie bird. But seriously though, he's married to a great family. 7 years ago, Anne and I went over to Australia for the first time for Christmas, and we were so warmly and generously welcomed by Pete and Carolyn and the family. It really was, we felt at home straight away, and we really do appreciate how very readily they took us into their family. I think Dave's doing really well to extend that family. We really do appreciate it. But I know that Dave and Amanda get on really well, and it was mentioned in the speech today that they are good friends. And even when we hear them, when they don't realise we're around, they do get on really well together. There doesn't seem to be any bickering, any fighting. I'm sure they have a long and happy marriage together. Now, I think that Anne and I are so fortunate to have such truly great in-laws. We really are. We really appreciate it. And, love is blind, but marriage is a real eye-opener. It's a good job we're not superstitious, because we all flew out on Friday the 13th. We thought, blimey, if the plane crashes, that's the family wiped out. And coincidentally, it's Friday again, and Amanda took 13 steps down to get married.
Awesome.
Talk to each
So, for those of you who are following along at the start, we're down to D in our acronym of PADMA. 17? Well, I got money on like 50, so you guys are going to have to suffer through some stuff. The next person I'd like to invite up to the microphone is actually a person I have spent quite a bit of time with. I've actually seen this person looking under rocks for snakes and spiders in a backyard of Bean Lee while I was standing beside him with a beer going, "What are you doing, mate? There's plenty of them around here."
This is my speech. I loved it today, having a drum viewing. Which was for once wasn't on fire, which was probably. Anyway, well, what a reception. I don't mean this reception. I mean the reception of me coming up here to speak, so thank you very much. It's been a very nice of you.
Can't see you.
Sorry, where would you like me to stand? Yeah. See, it happened straight away within 3 hours. Yes, darling, yeah. One foot. I'm going to start with thanking the Sims. And by the Sims, I actually mean all of you in general. And especially Pete and Carolyn, of course. Pete, thank you for your very kind words, by the way. I decided to leave England for a number of reasons. One, I kept getting beaten up, but you don't like people with short hair in England and football talks. I think they just want to beat them up, and I don't. So anyway, it doesn't matter. So I decided to leave England for a number of reasons. That was one of them. And I decided to go to Australia. And Australia, immediately for me, felt like a place I want to live. You know, a place I can settle down and be happy. Because it's just an amazing place. And for those of you who haven't been, you must go. You will. You better have. So I was in Australia, I was living in Melbourne with Matthew, which is one of the other reasons I went, by the way. My best man, Shaggy, who I went to school with. Thanks for that, by the way. Can I have a quick round of applause for Shaggy? Earlier, and I moved in with Matthew, and just found it the easiest place to live, you know? £1 was about $3 to the pound at the time, so it was even easier to live than it normally. And it's a wonderful place, and how I met Amanda is indirectly through Matthew, because Amanda was, and she ended up living with Matthew's brother and Matthew's girlfriend at the time. And that's how I actually met Amanda. And from that moment on, I fancied this little cute little curly haired blonde, and I had another girlfriend at the time, and I think another somewhere else, but another story. I got together, Amanda actually moved in with me, because I was desperate for a housemate and talked her into it. And then we moved in, five and a half years ago, and have been together since, and it's been just the best time. It's just changed me completely. Everything I think about the world, everything that is my world, has changed completely because Amanda moved in with me that day.
You're clean now.
I'm clean, I'm good now, I'm nice now. I wasn't good. I'm washing everything. You're amazed at what I was like. The Sim family. I went up to Coffs Harbour and I met Pete and Carolyn. And at the time I had this big beard and long hair and looked what I think Jesus would have looked like. And that was what I was going for.
Hey, Pink, no mention of God. You can't be that.
Yeah, but Jesus is alright.
Oh, okay, sorry.
So, I a bit of a hippie and everything, but they took me in. And since that day, since I've ever met Pete and Carolyn, they've been my family away from my family. And they've really looked after me, and they've treated me as they would treat a son, and forever will I be truly grateful for that. So thank you, Pete and Carolyn. If she'd have been in white today, I would have actually been saying the vows to her with Amanda at the top of the steps. Because doesn't she look good? Virtual world of these bloody people everywhere in the world you go. If you ever meet a Sim, I guarantee it's one of these. For all of the Sims, and all of the people in Australia who helped my emigration, I suppose. And thank you very much. So please have just a little sip for the Sims. 21. I like it when I don't have any plans in the week. I don't have to see anybody else. I just have just Amanda to myself. We cook, we sit together, we talk, she is my perfect companion. She really is. And when she goes away from business as she does so often, it's so depressing for me. I sit around bored. I get to watch my Animal Planet, which is nice. Honestly, you really do complete me. I love you so much. So, so much. You can see that today. Thank you very much. Long, happy life. Don't leave it too long before you have your first baby. Love from the heart. To Amanda and Dave, your best wishes on your wedding day. I'm wishing you a long and happy future from Dr. Buckley. Apparently he took a cyst out of Min's leg at some point. I was just asked to read it. All the very best. We are all thinking about you. Have a lovely day. Enjoy from Roving Ravens. Again, from Auntie Mary, Auntie Nett, Uncle Bob and families. Congratulations to you both and have a wonderful day from the girls at Kings Road Chelsea.
Yeah! Woo! When you're ready, okay, if you can't see me at any point, then you know I'm wrong. What a task it is to be the bride, speak last, in a room full of people that you know and love and have the most amazing memories and moments with. And I'm feeling a little bit loved up right now. A little bit drunk and emotional, so bear with me if I ramble on, cry, whatever. I apologise in advance, but it's my night, my moment. I'm not eating for weeks.
You look great.
That too. No, it's not. I have this little note, and what I've written in pink is what I've been thinking about while I've been awake at night for like the last week. And then I've been making notes throughout the day, so bear with me if I kind of jump all over the place. There's not a beginning, middle, or an end. It's just a big mess. Of our lives today. So thank you. Dave did touch on this subject where he thanks people who travelled from far and wide across the quarter, but one person he did not mention is my cousin Anara, who travelled from Zanzibar. So love her. Thank you. I wouldn't have got married in that. Okay, point number two. Jimenara!
That's the biggest joke that's going to kill me.
I have been going mad for that night. I can't really get a promise.
Ladies and gentlemen, father of the bride, we'd just like to have one more quick word and then I'll just do some formality stuff. Before you leave, 62. I was on 65. You arsy bastard.
You're lost, maybe. I'm going to refuse me, Sim, and I'm representing you. Lillian, a man of his grandparents, Lillian and Jim, they're Max. Max would have loved to have been here tonight, but unfortunately, he's just not well enough to travel this distance. So I'm representing all the Sims who were unable to be here. So on behalf of them, I wish you very well, happiness, and good health for many, many years to come.
Phil, let it fill.
Let it do cut Phil.
What air? I'm waiting for Amanda. Ready? Pretty big.
Dun, dun, dun.
Ready when you are.
Yeah, I
don't
want it to. Make
a wish on it.
Okay, now you get.
Huh? Bye, man.
Hey.
Yeah, you gotta hold that, Amanda. You gotta get closer to the light because otherwise your face will be getting dark.
Can we hold it on the bottom?
Oh.
Can you see that my dress is flammable?
Wait, hold it. One, two, three.
Let's go.
Oh, perfect.
What?
Oh. Hold the bottom. You see here?
No, wait. Oh.
No.
Up.
There you go. And off, hands off, hands off. I've watched yourself. Off the top! What are you doing?
Higher, higher.
What? Don't release, it's too fast, okay, guys?
Oh, Jesus Christ!
Oh,
we go 3, 2,
I keep missing Amanda every time.
Send it home. Go on.
All the way to England.
Join the ping pong ball.
Jackie.
Let go.
Okay, you guys, when it's ready, hold it higher and then release it.
Open it.
Ready?
Yep.
Yeah.
That?
There you go.
I'm trying to,
but I'm
putting
the bottom because the bottom's split.
See, that one's like. Can we swap with.
Someone.
Can you swap?
Kiwani, my vehicle.
Shims?
Yeah.
Sorry.
Normal.
trouble for two people to light a big bonfire from each side, and two fires come together. That's a medieval practice going back thousands and thousands of years.
Round the side, Pete. Yeah, I'll help you. Come on, Pete, let me have a go.
There we go. Get
in the bigger
like that.
That'll do,
eh? Yeah, yeah.
All right.
Get in a bit.
It's on its way up.
It's all right. It's all right. It's good.
Officially open the free bar.
Let's go. I think there should be some naked dancing in front of this bar.
Oh, is it correct? No, I have to put my tie back on.
We'll come out ritual first.
When was the last time you tied a tie?
No, you used to have bonfires everywhere, but nowadays you really have nice things.
Yeah. How are your feet? Sore. Come over here.
Oh, fabulous. Oh, we'll have a little ceremony.
Oh, yes.
What's the diet?
That's beautiful. Okay, looking together. Look at her. Yeah. Getting closer together. Okay. Oh, no, too close.
I got it.
So, also special on our special day. So, thank you to all of you guys. Now we're going to dance. We've been practicing this dance, but I have this really long dress on, and we didn't practice in this dress, so I apologize if I trip or stumble.
It's very, very extraordinary. It's even more than anyone that you adore. Is all that I can give to you. And make it take my heart and please don't break it.
Oh, it
was made for me and you. O is for the only one I see. V is very, very extraordinary. Is even more than anyone that you know can love. Is all that I give to you. Yeah.
fantastic. You know, we've done about so many traditions tonight, but I'm so throwing the bouquet. Because it seems like so much fun. So, all the girls who are single or not married, and boys, David, you're in marriage. Wrong down here. Everybody come down here, and then I can throw the bouquet. And then we can just get on with it. Come on, get to it. Boys, girls, whatever you like, you know? It's not a tradition for anything. Rick, Kevin, Gazza, John, Sarah, you're the very best down here.
Don't threaten the ocean.
Emma! Emma! Emma!
Don't threaten the ocean.
Big throw, man.
Woo!
That was so weird. Watch out!
London is on.
Wow.